எட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், ஃபோர்த் செமஸ்டரில் ஸ்பெக்ட்ரோஸ்கோப்பி பேப்பரில் செகண்ட் சாப்டர் ஆகிட்டுள்ள மைக்ரோவேவ் அண்ட் இன்ஃப்ராரெட் ஸ്പെക്ട്രോസ്കോപ്പിയാണ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ അതിൽ ഫസ്റ്റ് സിലബസിൽ വരുന്ന ഫസ്റ്റ് പാർട്ട് തന്നെ നോൺ റിജിഡ് റൊട്ടേറ്ററിൻ്റെ റൊട്ടേഷൻ സ്പെക്ട്രം ഓഫ് നോൺ റിജിഡ് റൊട്ടേറ്ററാണ്. സോ ബിഫോർ കമ്മിങ് ടു ദ ടോപ്പിക് ഐ വിൽ ഗിവ് യു എ ബ്രീഫ് ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് വാട്ട് ഈസ് മൈക്രോവേവ് സ്പെക്ട്രോസ്കോപ്പി. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ആൾറെഡി യു ഹാവ് സ്റ്റഡീഡ് ഇൻ യുവർ ഡിഗ്രി ക്ലാസ്സസ്. സോ യു നോ ദിസ് മൈക്രോവേവ് സ്പെക്ട്രോസ്കോപ്പി ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ദ റൊട്ടേഷൻ ഓഫ് ദി മോളിക്യൂൾസ്. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് മെയിൻലി കൺസേൺഡ് വിത്ത് ദ ഓർ ദ സ്പെക്ട്രോസ്കോപ്പി ഇൻ ദ മൈക്രോവേവ് റീജിയൻ. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നോൺ ആസ് ദ മൈക്രോവേവ് സ്പെക്ട്രോസ്കോപ്പി ആൻഡ് ഈസ് കൺസേൺഡ് വിത്ത് ദ സ്റ്റഡി ഓഫ് റൊട്ടേറ്റിംഗ് മോളിക്യൂൾസ്. ദെൻ അതിൻ്റെ എനർജി റേഞ്ച് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ദ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി റേഞ്ച് ഓഫ് മൈക്രോവേവ് റേഡിയേഷൻ ഈസ് 3×10^12 Hz ആണ്. ദെൻ എവറി മോളിക്യൂൾ ഈസ് അസോസിയേറ്റ് വിത്ത് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് എനർജി. വൈബ്രേഷണൽ എനർജി ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ഹാവ്, റൊട്ടേഷണൽ എനർജി, ദെൻ ഇലക്ട്രോണിക് എനർജി ആൻഡ് സിമിലർ അതർ ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് എനർജി ഈസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഈച്ച് മോളിക്യൂൾ. Then a molecule having this energy, suppose a molecule undergoes a rotation and a transition from one rotational level to another rotational level takes place within the same vibrational level. So vibrational energy is also there. Vibrational energy is it is infrared. Its energy is higher than that of the microwave region. So within a single vibrational level, several rotational levels are possible. Suppose we deal with a vibration suppose we deal with a transition between one rotational level to another rotational level within the same vibrational level, so that is termed as a pure rotational spectra. So we can represent like this. Suppose we have a vibration level here and another vibrational level here. So this vibration, the first vibrational level, this is the ground vibrational level, V equal to zero, and this is the first vibrational level. So within this V equal to zero, we have different rotational levels. Suppose we are considering a transition from like this, that is from the ground state, this is the different rotational levels, zero rotational, one with the quantum number 0, 1, 2, etc. So from within the same vibrational level, if the transition occurs, if the rotational transition occurs, then it is known as a pure rotational spectra. All these are you have studied in a this degree classes. For further reading, you can take the textbooks like SOPLA, etc., that which we have you have followed in your degree classes. Now for the PG classes, we have the text reference text is Arul Das, and that is available in our department also, and also in our library. Then now rotation of a body can be described in terms of its rotational inertia, or it is called the moment of inertia. And we have three different types of principal moments of inertia associated with a molecule, that is Ia, Ib, Ic, etc. So where ABC are the axes, the three mutually perpendicular axes. Usually Ia is the three moments of inertia of the substance about three different axes. All these axes are passing through the center of gravity of the molecule. Suppose one axis, if it is Ia, means it is an axis which is Ia is the moment of inertia about the bond axis, we can say. Suppose we have two molecules like this, then this is the bond axis, then this is the center of gravity, and it is the rotation or the moment of inertia of the molecule about this molecular axis, that is termed as Ia. And perpendicular to Ia, we have two different axes also, which is again passing through the center of gravity. One is taken as Ib and the other one is taken as Ic. Now depending upon the value of Ia, Ib and Ic, molecules are mainly classified into four types. First one is linear molecules, then symmetric tops we have, then spherical tops is is there, then asymmetric topsies are there. The first type of molecules are classified as linear molecules. As the name indicates, these are arranged in straight lines, and examples for such molecules are HCl, CO2, etc. In which, suppose we consider the three axes, the A axis is the molecular axis, B and C are the perpendicular axis to molecular axis. Then, suppose we take the moment of inertia of this type of molecule along the molecular axis. In this case, the value of moment of inertia about the bond axis or the molecular axis is equal to 0. And usually we have two other axes which are perpendicular to the bond axis. And suppose we take the value of IB and IC, and in this case of molecules, it is found that IB and IC both are found to be equal. So a molecule which satisfies these conditions, which are termed as the linear molecules. Now the second type of molecules are the symmetric tops. An example for symmetric top molecule is the CH3Cl molecule. So in CH3Cl, suppose we draw the diagrammatic representation, then the pictorial representation is like this, CH3. So 1H here, 1H here, 1H here, then Cl here. So it looks like a top. Then this is the bond axis which we have already taken, that is a CCl bond is the bond axis in this case. And suppose we find out the moment of inertia about this bond axis, CCl axis, then it is found to be non-zero. And we can consider two mutually perpendicular axes perpendicular to the bond axis here, and that two values are found to be equal. So in the case of symmetric top molecules, Ia is equal to so generally in this case Ia is not equal to 0, and Ib is usually equal to IC. So that is a general symmetric top. So this type of molecules, they spins like a top. So they name symmetric tops. Now depending upon these values of Ia, Ib, IC, the symmetric top molecules are again classified into prolate symmetric tops and oblate symmetric tops. Prolate and oblate symmetric tops. Prolate and oblate. Now in the case of prolate symmetric tops, we have Ia that is less than Ib. So in the case of prolate symmetric top molecules, Ia is less than Ib, and Ib and Ic both are equal. So that is the case of prolate symmetric top molecules, and example for such molecules are CH3Cl, then CH3F, etc. are examples for these prolate symmetric top molecules. Now coming to the case of oblate symmetric top molecules, in that case we have Ia is equal to Ib, then which is less than Ic. Ia is equal to Ib, which is less than Ic. And example for such a oblate type symmetric top molecules are BF3, BCl3, etc. are examples for this oblate symmetric top molecules. So here Ia is able, two of the moment of inertia are the same, and the other one is different, and depending upon the value of that one, whether it is greater than or equal to the third one, we can divide that into prolate symmetric tops and oblate symmetric tops. Now the third type of molecule is the spherical tops. In spherical tops, all the three principal moments of inertia of the molecule are equal. And example for spherical tops, are CH4, that is methane, then SF6, etc. are examples for these spherical tops. So this in spherical tops, all the principal moment of inertia are equal, and that is Ia equal to Ib equal to Ic. Now the fourth category of molecule is the asymmetric top. In asymmetric top molecules, all the moments are distinct. So Ia not equal to Ib, not equal to Ic. So majority of the molecules which we are familiar, or most of the molecules belongs to this category. Let's say examples are H2O, then we have CH3OH, then CH2, CH, Cl, etc. are examples for asymmetric tops. And majority of the molecules belongs to this group of So we have four types, depending upon the value of this moment of inertia, we have four types of molecules: linear molecules, symmetric tops, spherical tops, and asymmetric tops. Now in spectroscopic studies, we usually deal with the energy values in centimeter inverse that you already know. Suppose we have the energy in electromagnetic radiation, or these microwave radiations are electromagnetic radiation, and in electromagnetic radiation, nu lambda is equal to C. So, so energy of molecule is given by E is equal to h nu. So corresponding to a particular energy value, we have a corresponding frequency value. And that frequency value, particular frequency value, you can express that in the value of lambda and also in the value of 1 by lambda. And this 1 by lambda, it is known as the wave number and is represented as nu bar. So value, this unit of lambda is meter, so unit of nu bar is meter inverse, and usually we will take this in the unit of centimeter inverse. We will express that in the unit of centimeter inverse, because spectroscopy, and that is nammalkalum kooduthal verunathu adu chemistry illakka delay enaana appo oru material study la main property. So in order to identify the material and also to study the property of the material, we use the spectroscopic data. So we have the unit, usually use the unit of these energy values in the unit of centimeter inverse. So actually, how we will get these values of energy in the unit of centimeter inverse, that we can see. Suppose we have E is equal to h nu, then suppose we divide it with the h c. So what happens, this h and h get cancelled, then nu by c is equal to nu divided by c is nu lambda. So we will get 1 by lambda, that is equal to nu bar. So in order to obtain energy in the unit of wave number, we have to divide the original energy in the unit of joule. Joule varuna unit ne namaku hc kondu divide edamadi. So hc kondu divide edayunnal namaku energy in joules divided by hc, that you will get the energy value in centimeter inverse or wave number, and that is represented as this epsilon here. So usually energy is represented in the unit of epsilon in the case of spectroscopy. So in order to obtain that value, we have to divide the original joule energy into divide with the hc, then this epsilon multiplied with hc, that you will get the energy value in the unit of joules if epsilon is in the unit of meter inverse. If it is centimeter inverse, in centimeter inverse, first of all you have to change that centimeter inverse into meter inverse and multiply it with the hc in the standard units or SI units, then you will get the value of energy in joules. Next, how these a molecule, rotating molecule, interact with the radiation. Suppose we have molecule, dipole, diatomic molecule with having a dipole moment, permanent dipole moment or a molecule, and it has a dipole moment with which is along the bond axis, along the bond axis. So that molecule you can represent like this, plus charge and minus charge separated by a distance. And if the molecule undergoes rotation about an axis perpendicular to its bond, suppose the molecule undergoes rotation about an axis perpendicular to the bond axis, so the next position will be like this, plus position here and minus position here. The next one, it will be like this, plus here, then minus here, then again it will be like this. It comes to the case of minus here, then plus here, then again it comes to the initial position, plus here, minus here. So as the molecule undergoes this type of rotation, the electric field is, because the positions of the dipoles changes because of the charges changes, it is associated with an electric field, and this electric field is able to interact with the coming electromagnetic radiation, and that will lead to a pure rotational spectrum.
of the molecule. So in the case of if the molecule is of having dipole moment is zero, initially the molecule is not having any dipole moment, in that case we cannot expect this type of a variation, and such type of molecules will not produce any type of these rotational spectra. Examples are H2, N2, etc. type of diatomy molecules, then CO2, or then CS2 type of molecules, etc. And also spherical top molecules also do not possess a permanent dipole moment, and so they do not show any rotational spectra. So homonucleus diatomy molecules like H2, N2, etc. and also these linear molecules like CO2, CS2, etc. and spherical top molecules do not possess this permanent dipole moment. So they do not show any rotational spectra. Suppose we make a substitution, isotopic substitution on these substances or these materials or these molecules, then also that is that type of molecule is also not able to produce this dipole moment. And so in the case of molecules, linear molecules which is having a moment of inertia, we know that in the case of linear molecules, if it is of having a moment of inertia about the bond axis, that will be very small, and so rotation about this bond axis, that also does not produce any change in dipole moment. So the necessary condition for producing this rotational spectra is that the molecule should be associated with a dipole moment, and there should be change in dipole moment during the rotation of the molecule. So if the rotation is about the bond axis, then in that case it will not produce any change in dipole moment. So although the molecule is having a permanent dipole moment, it will not produce rotational spectra, because the two conditions that should be obeyed in this case is the molecule should have a permanent dipole moment, and also the rotation of the molecule should produce a change in the dipole moment. So by this reason, a linear molecule do not show any change in dipole moment if it is undergoes a rotation about its bond axis. So the variation of this direction of dipole moment direction we can represent like this in the previous case. So continuously the dipole changes like this, and correspondingly, suppose we represent the fluctuations in the electric field, we can mark the fluctuations on the electric field like this. Now usually in order to study the spectral transition, we should have a thorough knowledge of the quantum mechanics, but we are using only the results of the quantum mechanics to study the spectroscopic data. The transition from a rotational state I to a state J is determined by the transition moment. The transition moment is given by mu ij, that is equal to integral psi I star psi I mu psi I d tau. That is the expression for the transition moment. Transition moment is given by the expression mu ij is equal to integral psi I star mu psi j d tau. So these are the mu I and mu j are the two wave functions for the rotational states I and j. I and j are the two rotational states, and the psi I and psi j are the wave function, corresponding wave functions associated with that rotational states. And this is the expression for the transition moment, and by the quantum mechanical study we will get the following conclusions from the quantum mechanical study. That is, in order to produce a rotational spectra, the molecule must have a permanent dipole moment, and also the transitions are allowed only between adjacent rotational levels. That is another condition which we are getting is that delta J is equal to plus or minus 1, where J is the, we already know, it is the rotational quantum number. J can have a change of plus or minus 1, plus sign for absorption and minus for sign for emission.